Hello, my name is Michelle, and I will be your tour guide as we explore the Revised Total Coliform Rule. The Iowa Department of Natural Resources has put together this video to help you navigate the new rule, which became effective April 1st of 2016. This rule applies to all public water supplies in the United States, not just in Iowa. In a nutshell, this rule is designed to increase the protection of the public health by reducing the potential pathways that bacteria can find to get into your drinking water supply. One way it does this is by helping systems find and fix possible problems. In addition to the information provided in this video, a written summary of the RTCR can be found on the EPA's fact sheet. We provided a link to this website in the description box below this video. As you probably guessed, the revised total coliform rule has made a few changes to the original rule. One of the biggest changes under the RTCR is the elimination of the old non-acute maximum contaminant level violation. You might know it better as a non-acute MCL. This is the violation that was issued when multiple sample results showed the presence of total coliform bacteria. Since this rule eliminated the violation, it also eliminated the need to do public notice. Instead, the RTCR now has you look over your water system and attempt to find and correct any issues that might be causing the contamination. To help you find and fix the potential problems, you are provided a checklist that will teach you how to perform a level one assessment. This assessment requires you, the owner or operator, to inspect your water supply for sanitary deficiencies or hazards that might be contributing to the problem in your water. In a separate video, I will walk you through parts of the assessment to show you how easy and helpful the checklist is. Another change, which will benefit many of Iowa's smaller systems, is in the reduction in the number of extra samples that are required after a routine sample shows the presence of bacteria. Instead of collecting 4 repeat samples, you are now only required to collect 3. Another benefit for systems that collect monthly samples, you no longer have to collect 5 more samples in the following month. Now you just go back to your normal number of routine monthly samples. For our water systems that are only required to collect a bacteria sample each quarter, you still have to collect some more samples the next month, but now it's only 3, not 5. Don't worry about memorizing the number of samples you need to take. If you end up with a sample that happens to show the presence of bacteria, DNR staff will walk you through the process. While I'm thinking about it, be sure to take this opportunity to update your bacteria sampling plan. You know, the thing you get asked about during each inspection? There is an updated template to help you out on the DNR website. The last noteworthy change the rule deals with are the seasonal supplies. These are water systems that are not open or serving the public year-round. Any seasonal system is now required to collect a bacteria sample each month during their operating season. In addition, seasonal systems must conduct startup procedures each year prior to opening. This procedure consists of completing a checklist and visually inspecting the well, treatment if you have it, and your water storage units. Just like the level one assessment, this checklist is helpful and easy to perform, but I'll still walk you through it in a separate video. A key part of this startup procedure is collecting a safe bacteria sample before you serve water to the public. Remember that if you have multiple distribution systems, you'll need to collect a clean bacteria sample from each one before you open it to the public. This startup sample should be taken after all actions of your startup procedure have been completed. Just don't do it more than 30 days prior to opening. Good news, if you take the startup sample in the same month you plan to open, it can do double duty and count as your routine sample. Just give your favorite DNR rep a call if you have any questions about it counting or not. The startup sample should be taken at a location noted in your sampling plan, and it must be labeled as sample type, routine, facility ID, 950. If you have more than one distribution system, check your permit for the right numbers. And sample point ID, SUP, that stands for startup procedure. Well, that about wraps up this introduction to the revised total coliform rule. Thanks for taking the time to watch the video, and hopefully I've answered some of your questions. But don't hesitate to give your favorite DNR rep a call. We are all here to help.